Good morning, friends. I am Tanvi Bansal from class 7N. My topic for today is organ trafficking, a crime that has finished the nation. India is a land of diversity and richness, but also a land of contradictions. In India, we are some of the richest people and the poorest. In India, we have software, scientific and technological brains. Yet, in some parts of the country, illiteracy abounds. Today, India is a steadily growing hub of medical tourism. And yet, many people are unable to get facilities such as healthcare. Now, despite the technological and medical advances, many children die of diarrhea and pneumonia, and young adults die of tuberculosis. The transport, transfer, recruit, and harbor of the organs of the living or deceased by means of threat, force, and abduction is called organ trafficking. The demand for organs is a persistent worldwide problem, and the demand significantly outstrips the supply. Consider the following statistics. In 2016 in America, 1,791,000 people were waiting for an organ transplant. Yet, in 2014, only 14,000 transplants happened. That year, 5,000 Americans died waiting for an organ. Unable to obtain an organ at home, the patients from rich countries might choose to travel to developing countries, buy an organ and have it transplanted. Here, in these countries, the organ brokers lure poor and uneducated individuals into selling their organs in promise for financial gain and a better future. The question arises, if selling organs is saving lives, why prohibit it? This is indeed a question that libertarians raise. They say that legal organ sales show the liberty of individuals and also financial low-income individuals. But the current medical consensus prohibits the trade of human organs. They say that human organs are not a commodity to be bought and sold. Also, the donors receive only a small fraction of the $100,000 or $200,000 typically paid by patients and do not experience the rarely mentioned financial gain. Often, they also suffer from social deterioration of health and social isolation. Now, major steps towards establishing a sound and ethical system for availability of organs has been initiated. In year 1968, the Uniform Anatomical Gift Act was introduced. In this act, there are some conditions of which the patients can provide their organs to the needy people after their death, and it even provides conditions under which living donor transplant is permissible. Further advancements were made in 1984 when the National Transplant Organ Act was initiated. This opened a nationwide computer registry of organs. This was operated by the United Control System, but this also prohibits the buying and selling of direct organs. The WHO set of principles and guidelines by the organ transplant was approved on the 44th World Health Assembly. Besides these stringent laws and the act that have been introduced, there is a need of effort and there is a need of efforts by the government. Thank you.